Hey everybody, Jeremy from AltRider, and we're going to do the installation in a series for the Africa Twin 1100. We're doing this installation on the Adventure Sports. Everything's the same for the standard model, and we're going to start with the universal brackets, which is your base foundation, and then we'll migrate to lowers, uppers, and your reinforcement bar. So to start off with, guys, the tools that we're going to need, we have an N6 Allen key, I've got an extension driver, an M12 socket, and then a 14 millimeter spanner, 12 millimeter, and then correspondingly we've got a 14 millimeter socket. This is for just the universal bracket. Again, we're going to just start with the foundation and then we'll move to the next crash bar. So in the universal bracket kit, you'll receive your stainless steel brackets in production. They'll be grain finished. And to tell the difference, the rider's right-hand side is the longer one. It also has the PEM nut affixed on there, making installation a lot easier. So
rider's left-hand side
is the shorter one, so you can tell and make sure you guys identify the difference when you go to fit up. Then on to the hardware. We've got four M8 second socket head cap Allen screws, stainless, of course, M8 washers, zinc-plated M8 nuts to avoid any galling. So, and these are the nice serrated ones, which may make them lock in, making installation a lot easier, providing the locking effect. And then we've got a M14 zinc-plated through bolt, the two corresponding M14 washers. We don't need the nut because, of course, the PEM is residing there on the bracket. And then M8 socket head cap Allen, the longer screw, and its M8 washer and another serrated locking nut. And guys, when you purchase direct from AltRider, we send you the resealable Loctite bottle. The nice thing is after you do your installation, you can seal the bottle back up and bring this in your riding kit. A great little tip to do. Okay guys, so now we're gonna start in on the installation. We'll go ahead and you wanna remove either the OEM or any aftermarket skid plates before we get started. Because we're going to need to drop the exhaust as well. It's nice to not have the skid plate in case you drop any fasteners. And if you've got any panniers, go ahead and drop your pannier as well. And so now we'll get started with the rear hanger first with our M6 Allen. Go ahead and remove the rear hang bolt. You'll want to drive this guy straight out and make sure you keep. You can do this with the passenger peg left in place, or you can remove it. If you leave it in place, you want to take the fastener out, then the spacers, because you can't get them out in at the same time because it gets locked in there. So take these out together, and now we're ready to move down to the lower hanger. And then on the back side, I've got my there's the acorn nut that's on the back side. And then I'll drive this bolt all the way out. And then I've got my M12. And then now we've got the hanger off. And the only thing left now is on the front, we're gonna do the exhaust flange bolts. And not, again, we're onto an M12. An extension makes this a lot easier to reach in there, guys. So depending on how new your bike is, because of course these have been under high heat, but they should be able to break free. You might need to get a 3/8 drive. So M12, and go ahead and work off the acorn nuts off of the flanges. And there's four. So there we got one. And we'll just work our way through. And onto the other side. Now my exhaust is loose, but I want to walk it forward and down. I've got this hanger I've got to get around. So pull forward, and you guys just got to get off of the hanger. So we've got this little lip here. I'm going to pull forward, and then now I can set it forward off of the flanges. And because we've got the exhaust flap now has those stainless steel cables, we can let the exhaust just hang at this point in time. And now we're gonna take off our M14 and M8 frame bolts to put our universal brackets on. So for that, I'm gonna need my M 14 to take the larger one off. From the right hand side, I get a good clean shot, guys, with an extension on my M14. So I'm gonna be able to get in here to the bolt head, and then I'll come and grab my nut with my spanner, and then I'll break this one free, and now I can keep rolling this through. And again, this is where we've got the two spacers in there, and I'll try to do my best to show those to you guys. Let's get the nut off. And your bolt should not be under tension unless your engine is shifted. It could be under tension, and therefore you might need a drift. All right, guys, now we're doing the lower M8 bolt a lot easier than our M14, and there's no spacers that I have to worry about. Again, I get a nice clean shot with my ratchet, and I'll break that free and then walk that all the way off. And then I'll walk my nut out. And again, your motor could have shifted and there'll be tension on this bolt, but it should come right out. And we won't use this again. We'll save this. And now we'll go grab our universal brackets, set them in there, and set the bolts. Okay, guys, reminder again, my PEM and the longer bracket is gonna go on my rider's right-hand side. We're gonna get set up and feed through on our rider's left-hand side, and that leaves us for the larger M14 and the M8. I went ahead and set my washers up, and then of course I only need my M8 nut on that side. And so let's go set these up and make sure that we capture the two spacers on the larger M14 bolt. So I wanna go ahead and get started. Because the M8 can get trapped in here, I wanna get that one started as I bring these two together and onto the frame as we walk these on. If you're not lucky enough that your frame plates were able to hold your spacer, now we're gonna need to fish this in as we drive our M14 bolt on. And so this is where, guys, a magnet can be really helpful for setting this right in place. All right, guys, so once you get that M14 in there, that's your hardest of, portion of the whole piece. And the good thing is once your universal brackets are on, you'll never have to take them off, because then you can have a full access, and then you only have to bolt through this flange. I've now got just my last M8 fastener, the front one, the socketed cap. So a little thread locker, that guy's pushed through. And so then we're just gonna get our nut started. And remember, it's that serrated nut, which is great because it'll actually bite into the stainless steel. We should be fine to go ahead and snug these guys up, but if we do find that we have any sort of fitment issues when we go to install our bars, we can always loosen them because they have an allowance to make installation easier. But I'm gonna go ahead and tighten these up at this stage.
If you are installing the lower crash bars, do not reinstall the exhaust until after the lowers are installed. Open the Africa Twin 1100 lower crash bar installation video now. If you are only installing the upper crash bars and no lowers, continue watching for reinstallation of the exhaust.
But now I'm gonna go ahead and put install the exhaust back on now that I'm almost done. When we go to hang the exhaust back on, we'll wanna get on this hanger first. It does make it easier, guys, to just drop the passenger peg. So you've got the 10 socket millimeter for pulling these off. Go ahead and drop this off out of your way. Then I'll cradle the exhaust because I've gotta be feeding into the exhaust ports as I then bring it up to the back. Because I got my foot peg out of the way, it's nice and easy to align. And I'm going to get these threads started. One of the elements that has happened is now that our foot peg bracket is sitting on top of the flange, our foot peg has come out 3/16, and you might want to bring your brake lever out 3/16 to keep the same pattern. So you can put a little bit of leverage and get your aluminum foot peg to easily bend out just the 3/16, so that now the whole assembly, and you'll get a little bit more clearance off of your crash bar. Now we're gonna hang the rest of the exhaust. I grabbed the middle bolt, but I wanna make sure that this star washer, go ahead and slide underneath here, is in between the actual OEM bracket
and the rubber exhaust hanger. And then I can drive that all the way through.
You might want to use an awl to get the rubber grommet and the exhaust hanger aligned. And then now that I've got that set in there, I can bring, a great trick is to use the flange on the nut to then allow me to bring that up through the back. Once you've used your awl and you've gotten your mid hanger lined up, you can also pull on the exhaust to help bring it forward, because of course we've spaced this off by 3/16. And then you'll want to make sure you're pressing inward to get that collared shoulder spacer inward so that the threaded bolt makes it through and you can actually then get the nut started. That'll make it just a little bit easier. And then again, with an M12 spanner holding the nut in the back, you can then just tighten up this assembly now. All right, guys, now we just got our exhaust flange nuts to put on. And so this is where you want to lock each one of these, the flanges on, right? And then we'll get each thread started, because you want to walk this whole assembly up tight, right? We've still left these two rear hangers loose. And as we get each one on, we'll slowly get all four in and then slowly, sequentially, tighten this whole assembly up. Okay, so now we can slowly begin to snug up each one, and it'll seat the exhaust into those copper gaskets. So I'm gonna do a little bit at a time on each one of these. All right, and then you'll feel those flanges bottoming out. And now we can come back along and snug up our final fasteners here and our M6. The exhaust hangers, now that we know we've cleanly sucked the exhaust up.